before I knew it, you know, I was reading and I said, this really makes sense. I became a big fan of this method. I knew my fourth graders were going to have a wide variety of abilities, and the flexibility of this method really appealed to me. I knew I could make it work.
Marianne, what was it that sparked your interest in the four square writing method?
Well, I was teaching writing and speaking here at Mary Grove a couple of semesters ago, and I still am, and I invited Diane Brown to come to my class to teach them some method that she found successful with her students. She came and talked about the four square, which I really had not heard about, but I was sold on it. I said, this is really a good idea. And then, since I was teaching and still am the writing and speaking, I used it with my graduate students, and it was so helpful for them to prepare in a short time a coherent piece of writing. And not only that, but to teach this to their students to do the same for their field work. So what I found it was a great guide. It's simple, and it was really worked well with the students, especially those who had a little trouble getting started with writing.
You know, I think that's a really important point, Marianne. The fact that those folks we have the hardest time reaching, the ones have the most to say, and they just can't get down on paper. So the best thing about Foursquare is it works for all different type of people at all different grade levels, all different ability levels, and all types of writing. I've seen kindergartners use this to write, and I've seen it, and I've actually used it in college to write myself. I used it to prepare for my PhD exams.
I used it this summer in summer school with children, and it really was a great technique to help them talk about a person that they admire. We organized it with a four square, and they turned out some beautiful work.
That's great.